We think this needs to be our moment on Thanksgiving Day. This ain't our family's moment. This is not what we're all about.
No, our turkeys don't look that beautiful.
We don't have a beautiful turkey. It does not win the turkey beauty pageant.
No.
But this turkey, the way we're doing it, turns out so moist and juicy that you're gonna wanna do your turkey like this every single year. You know, I'm all about easy, dependable, and just get in the kitchen recipe. So today I brought in my mama Peggy because she's gonna show me how she does her quick and easy slow roasted turkey. You wanna show me how you do it?
Okay. First,
you're in charge.
Okay, what are you putting those on for?
I don't wanna get salmonella all over me.
You gotta get your hands in there and you gotta do this. And you see your hands going in there?
Yeah, I see them.
All right, you gotta keep doing that until you get that skin all loosed in there.
Okay.
And so that's what you do, and you get to bring it all the way down the side, and the top, over here, and get all that stuff. Mm, this is nice and cold.
Nice and cold?
Yeah. Get it on
it's
the
like
side.
He's getting a massage. I wish you'd do that to me. How long does it take to thaw?
Well, it depends on how big your turkey is, but you know, you want to set it out at least a couple of days.
A couple of days.
And be sure you put something underneath that turkey.
Yeah, because it does
you'll have it all over your refrigerator.
A lot of juice.
Yeah.
Okay, so now we're going to do butter.
Yep, take the butter.
Okay.
Take the butter
you
in your hand.
You want to do it?
Well, I was just going to show you how.
Okay.
Okay.
Mama's doing it all. This is kind of typical of Thanksgiving Day,
okay,
where my mama takes charge of all the cooking.
Okay, you got to get that butter everywhere.
So we're getting butter. Did you know that 50 million turkeys are eaten on Thanksgiving Day?
I wouldn't be surprised.
50 million. And do you know what else is a fun fact?
What's that?
Most people don't like turkey.
No.
You know why?
Why?
Because they all say it's dry.
Okay, now we're going to start putting salt in it.
Okay, I've got gloves on. Let me do something. I'll do it.
But you don't have butter on your hands.
All right, go. I'm just gonna like look at my nails. Okay, so now you're rubbing salt. You rub it under the skin or?
Under the skin, around the bend. You got to go everywhere.
In the carcass, don't forget. What? Oh, who's doing this, you or me? Okay, now what are you doing?
Putting a little pepper on it.
Okay, so as you can see, this is not winning a beauty contest. All right, but it is slathered in butter and salt, and you're actually going to put it in the refrigerator, and this is a dry brine, and it's going to season and tenderize the turkey overnight.
We need to put it in a bag.
Okay, but I'm gonna ask a favor.
What's that?
Can I wrap it in parchment paper before we put it in a bag? Because I would like to keep the plastic from touching the meat. Is that okay? You're okay if I do it that way? Okay, I'm just adding just a little twist to my mom's recipes. We're gonna wrap this guy up. You wanna pull another piece out for me?
Sure.
A big long one, big old long one. Go, 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 there you go. Okay, stick that underneath there, mama. Okay.
You do know you had to put flour in your bag.
Why?
It keeps it from bursting.
Bursting?
I call it busting myself, but
bursting.
Everybody else say bursting.
We don't want our turkey to burst.
I just put a couple of tablespoons, 2-3 tablespoons in.
See why my recipes never turn out? That was
But it's on the, if you look on the bag.
It tells you?
It tells you how much to put in. And you shake it up good. It tells you that this coats the inside of the bag. And It keeps it from
bursting. So the best way to get into the turkey is to actually just put your hand into the carcass, grab the hole where the neck is, and then lift it up. And then it'll go right in. Don't let the parchment slip off, mama. There we go. We did it. Booyah. Okay.
What a booyah.
Notice that my hands now are going to be beautifully clean.
But mine will be prettier because I have lots of butter on them.
True, touche. We're gonna improvise here.
Now remember, you gotta give it some air.
Okay, and you gotta poke some holes in it. We're gonna tie this turkey up. What I'm doing is moving that flour around. She got a little heavy-handed with the flour. Okay, there we go. So we're gonna cook it on its breast, and then 3/4 of the way through, we're gonna turn it back over. And this will keep all the juices going
flowing in there. I just cook it till it's done. But
she cooks it till it's done.
Yeah.
If you're gonna wanna cook it for 20 minutes for each pound, and then how you know it's done is you're going to open up the bag and move the leg. And if the leg just can turn and move around, then you're good. You can also use a meat thermometer and register 160.
Yes, you can.
Okay. All right, ready to go?
I'm all for it.
Okay, let's go put it in the oven.
Okay.
We're back with our turkey. Look how beautiful he is. Ain't she a beauty? This is a perfectly roasted turkey. Okay, what's the best way to do her?
Okay, I do it from the side. So you stick it down in there.
Wait. You're gonna pull his body apart.
Yep, the body's gonna fall apart.
Okay. Oh my goodness, here. It is so tender. It is actually falling off the bone. This is like a turkey home run. Okay, so we're putting our turkey that's literally falling off the bone because it's so succulent.
Oh, yes.
On a big carving board so that we can actually pull it off the bone. And we're gonna put it on this platter.
Look at that juice coming out of that turkey. Look at that. I gotta taste the turkey skin.
What you can do if you wanna make sure it stays moist is actually take a little bit of the drippings from the bottom of the pan and just sprinkle it over the meat to keep it moist. You can put it in your dressing. If you didn't stuff the turkey, you can make noodles with it. That's what we do. We do homemade noodles and you can make your gravy. So this is a great flavor base.
Some people like to keep their legs whole because a lot of people just like to eat a turkey leg. So you can just put them. Some people just like to have a turkey leg.
Mm-hmm. So for more tips, tricks, ideas, amazing recipes that are dependable, that will turn out, where we've worked out all the kinks for you, go to CherylStyle.com. Make sure you subscribe to this channel and like this if you love it, if you loved My Mama Peggy. And
come back and see us.
And please subscribe to my channel. Just Get in the Kitchen. We'll see you next time.